Okay, next. Possible isomers of the dibromo naphthalene. Dibromo naphthalene. So actually, here in this case, this is a naphthalene. Okay, here 1-chloro naphthalene. 1-chloro naphthalene. Now this is 2-chloro naphthalene. That means here monochloronaphthalenes are the two. Monochloronaphthalene are two isomers. Okay? Monochloronaphthalene. 1, 2. But suppose it is not 3-chloronaphthalene. It is not a 3-chloronaphthalene. Why? Because again it is a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay? That's it. Its numbering is different. Okay, so here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay. For suppose, this one is a 1-chloronaphthalene. Why? Because here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Again, we have to start the numbering from the substituent. Okay. For suppose, this is also 2-chloronaphthalene. This one 2-chloronaphthalene. Here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 2-chloronaphthalene. Okay. So here monochloronaphthalene derivatives are the two. Monochlorobenzene is 1. Monochlorobenzene is only 1. But monochloronaphthalene are the 2. Okay. Monochloronaphthalene derivatives are the 2. Okay. That's it. Now here, dichloro derivatives, okay, dichloro derivatives of naphthalene. So see this one, here 1,2 dichloro next 1,3 dichloro. Okay, 1,2, 1,3. 1,4, 1,4 dichloro. Cl. Here 1,5, 1,2,3,4,5. Or 1,2,3,4,5. 1,5. Okay, this Cl and this is Cl. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That is 1, 6. Okay, next one. 1, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, and finally here. This is 1,8. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Here we should not number, you should not give the numbering like this. 1, 3. That means 1, 2. Here 1, 2, 3. Through the ring we have to proceed the numbering. Okay, that is the 1,8. And next remaining isomers are also possible. Those are 2, 3. The numbering is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Numbering is same. So it's a 2,3 dichloro. The 2,3 dichloro naphthalene. Next. This one. Here this is 1,3. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. That means here it is a 1,3. So it equals to this one. 1,3 isomer. Okay, that's it. So it's not isomer. 1,3. Next one. For suppose this one. Here in this case, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. That means here 1,6. 1,6 already have written. Okay. So again, this is also not isomer. for suppose Cl and Cl. Here in this case, if you start numbering from this one, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. That means here 2, 6 is a different. It is a different 2, 6. You can next here Cl and this is the Cl. If you start the numbering from this side, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. That means here 2, 7. Okay, 2, 7. And similarly, Cl and Cl. It's not a 2, 8 because here this carbon has a substituent. So numbering you can give from this carbon. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. That means here 1, 7 is already written. So number of possible isomers. Number of possible isomers. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 10 dichloronaphthalene derivatives are exist. Okay, 10 dichloronaphthalene derivatives are exist. Next one. Here, monochloroanthracene. Okay, monochloroanthracene. Monochloroanthracene means here, this is the anthracene. This is the anthracene. Its numbering is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Different. Its numbering again different. Here in this case, we can see three different monochloro derivatives. Here I am saying monochloro. It is 1 chloro. And next one. Next one, 2 chloro, okay, 1 chloro, 2 chloro, and finally 9 chloro, okay, that is a 9 chloro, 3 monochloro derivatives, and write the dichloro derivatives of the anthracene, okay, you will get the so many isomers, okay, you will get the so many isomers. So monochloro and anthracene are the 3. Okay, no? That's it. So that is about the positional isomerism. Okay, no? Thank you. So write down this one.